professor of language and literacy education. My area is applied linguistics, and I've been in the department since the early 1990s. From July, I'll be associate dean of research, so my role will change, but I've been mainly working in the TESOL and modern language education programs here. I'm interested in second language learning from a number of different standpoints, but especially looking at the social, cultural, and cognitive aspects. And those come together under an umbrella term called language socialization. So I'm interested in language learning across the lifespan. When people come into new communities or cultures, including in their own language, and need to learn how to speak or write or use other media according to the local expectations. It might be in the sciences, it might be in the arts, it might be in other kinds of groups, but how do they learn the language and other semiotic means of those communities in order to become full participants in those communities. To do the kind of research I'm interested in, case study and ethnography are very effective because you can look at the individuals within their local contexts, and sometimes it's a small group, and I like to follow these individuals or small groups over time if possible to look at the processes of learning and engaging with cultures, and also to look at development and how they become more proficient or more competent in those new communities. So I've written quite a few things about qualitative interpretive research methods for that purpose. I've been interested in English in multilingual contexts, but about 10 years ago, I turned my attention more to Chinese and Chinese in global context and diaspora context, Chinese language learning by adults as well as by kids in heritage language programs. And I've done research in both of those contexts with adult Anglophone learners of Chinese and then with Chinese heritage learners of Chinese. And it's very interesting, especially as Chinese becomes a more widely taught and learned language internationally. So I like looking at these teaching learning contexts from at both the micro level of what's going on and also the macro level, the socio-political, ideological aspects, and then at the personal level in terms of identity and learners' trajectories. What do they want to do with Chinese in their lives, or Chineses and multiple varieties of Chinese? What is their purpose? How does that enhance their lives or complicate their lives in some cases? And it's English, Chinese, and then other languages for me. I've been teaching courses on theories of second language acquisition. So the course reflects my own shift in perspective from a more cognitive to a more sociocultural perspective. And within the classrooms, I try to cultivate this kind of community of practice that I also research in other spheres. And other courses I teach include case study research methods, and I had the pleasure of teaching that one time to students across the faculty in their different disciplinary areas, and similarly with an ethnography of communication, to see how one could do that kind of research in very different spheres: art education, museum education, math, science education, as well as language and literacy education.